Joining me now on this issue, our good friend Andy McCarthy. You know him as the author of the bestseller Ball of Collusion and as the assistant U.S. attorney for the Southern District of New York, leading the prosecution there on the 1993 World Trade Center bombing. And you see him on Fox, too. He joins us on the phone. Andy, always a pleasure. So glad to talk with you. Do you think that Trump would? Is he going to answer Raskin's letter, do you think? And is it smart for him to testify?
Well, I hope he doesn't, Dana. I hope he doesn't answer the letter rather than to politely say no. Of course, if the president did that, it would be the first polite thing he did. But I do think he should say no. If he were president, this would be a real separation of powers problem. You know, Congress doesn't get to subpoena the president. There's a reason why we have lots of very contentious congressional hearings and you never see the president or the vice president. You really even shouldn't see members of the White House staff testify. It would be just as inappropriate as if the Justice Department of the executive branch started to subpoena, clerical personnel in the different offices of the different lawmakers. They have to respect each other's different sphere. Now, at this time, Trump is no longer the president, which is why this impeachment trial is going to be presided over by a member of the Senate, Patrick Leahy, the president pro tem, rather than the chief justice of the Supreme Court, because the Constitution says that only happens for presidential impeachments. But I think, you know, we always have to remember with this thing that it's a political proceeding, not a legal trial.
Right.
And for purposes of the Democrats, it's a bad enough look to have a trial that is not going to be presided over by a judge. Now, if you're going to start treating Trump, who is in roughly the position of a criminal defendant, if this were a judicial trial, if you're going to treat him like he doesn't have basic due process rights, if you're going to treat him like it in a criminal trial, you would never be able to subpoena the defendant and tell him, you know, we want you to come in and explain this all to us, that, you know, we have a little Fifth Amendment thing that that prevents that from happening. So I just think the more things that they do that looks like this is a partisan show trial rather than something where they're respecting certain norms of due process, the worse it's going to look, because, you know, unless Trump does something really insane, we already know the outcome here. He's not going to be impeached. So all this is about how it looks, I think, at this point.
Yeah, which kind of is antithetical to what Biden was saying in the soundbite we played. He just wants the matter to go forward and unify the country. Well, you can't do that with a political trial. I mean, that doesn't make sense. I don't know if some of these other Republicans, you had a great piece, and I had not actually thought of this angle until I was reading your column over at NRO. It's titled Graham's Threat Does Not Help Trump's Defense, for those who want to read it. But you discussed Senator Lindsey Graham when he was speaking on cable news on Monday night, because he said he was kind of threatening Democrats. Look, if you're going to call, you know, witnesses, this is not going to go in your favor. And he was, you know, kind of throwing some threats and saber rattling. But you say that doesn't help him. Is he trying to help? You kind of have to ask that question now. After I read your column, I'm like, is he trying to help, though?
I think he is trying to help, but, you know, he's making a strategic error. When I was a prosecutor, we used to call defense lawyers who did this sort of thing undercover U.S. attorneys, because they were more help to us, I think, than they were to their own clients. You know, look, I think what he's trying to do, if you look at it politically, and we have to look at all of this politically, because, again, it's not a legal proceeding.
Right.
So I think the place where the Republican senators want to get to, the needle they need to thread, is they want to be able to look Trump supporters in the eye and tell them they fought the impeachment. But they want to be able to look the rest of the country in the eye and say they didn't approve of what happened on January 6th.
Right.
So the safe haven strategically they've tried to carve out for themselves is this very technical, legal, jurisdictional point about whether the Senate has constitutional authority to try a former president, a non-incumbent official.
Right.
So that enables them to say, we're fighting the impeachment, we're voting against the impeachment, but at the same time, it's a completely legal argument, and it keeps them away from the facts of January 6th. So with that as the background, if that's what your understanding of the chessboard is, then if you're Lindsey Graham, the more they do to call witnesses in and point people to the facts of what happened on January 6th, the less this presentation is about this narrow legal issue, and the more people are going to be focused on the horrific things that happened in the Capitol right. that day. So what he's trying to do, I think, is tell the Democrats, you know, look, we've done impeachment before. We haven't had to have witnesses. We get a bunch of gas bag lawyers for both sides to come in and tell us this is what we think happened. And, you know, we all know the outcome is always predetermined because we already know whether there's going to be enough votes to impeach or not. There, in our history, there's never been. There probably would have been with Nixon. But in the history of the United States, we've never had a president impeached because of the two-thirds supermajority. So you always know going in, you know, probably with 99% certainty what the outcome is going to be.
Right.
So what this is about at this point, I think, is containing political damage. And the Republicans trying to calculate what do we get hurt more by, you know, hyper defending the president against impeachment or looking like we're excusing what went on January 6th. Graham and the other Republicans want as little attention to the facts of January 6th as possible.
Right. And it seems like a kind of somewhat related to that, an issue that not just the Senate is dealing with, but the House as well. Last night with Green and Cheney, you brought up, we're speaking with Andy McCarthy, and you brought up a really good point in the jurisdiction that the Senate has over someone who isn't even in office anymore. I know the last time we spoke, you were giving some of the history of that. What if Democrats, and I'm curious as to how this would work and if this could even be possible. I mean, if they really do believe and if there is evidence to substantiate some, you know, accusation of criminality and potential conviction, couldn't they just handle that outside of Congress? I mean, couldn't they charge him with incitement outside of that and pursue it privately?
Absolutely. The Constitution is explicit on this point. It says that the penalty for impeachment is limited to removal and disqualification from future office, and any other penalties for the conduct that underlying the impeachment has to be, you have to go through the normal court processes. So the Constitution expressly contemplates the idea that a president who violates a criminal law or a civil law can be prosecuted or sued civilly. And in fact, we've seen that happen. I mean, with Nixon, with Clinton, we had the whole litigation involving Paula Jones, which was kind of what underlay the conduct that Clinton was ultimately impeached over. Mm-hmm. And if there are criminal offenses, it's always possible to bring a prosecution. That's why Ford pardoned Nixon. I don't think the criminal case against Nixon was particularly compelling. But Ford thought that the best thing for the country at that point was to pardon him and try to put Watergate in the rearview mirror. I think he actually was trying to unify the country as opposed to having a president now who likes to talk a lot about unifying the country. And then it seems to me everything he does is designed to, you know, pull us further apart. But that's a story for another day. But yes, absolutely. You're right. You can do criminal or civil.
Right.
The only thing about impeachment is removal and disqualification. That's it.
Goodness. So this, I do feel as though they're going to drag this on as long as possible. But I mean, at some point, maybe they'll get on with the rest of the nation's business instead of focusing so much on Trump for Biden's first 100 days. But I guess we'll see. Our good friend, Andy McCarthy. Andy, always appreciate your breakdown of these issues. And good to talk with you again. Thanks so much for your time.